All right, here we go. The first two qualifiers out in car number 116. The driver, the defending race winner out of Blairsville, Georgia, it is Jonathan Davenport. Jonathan Davenport in car number 116. And that Longhorn chassis, the defending Lucas Oil Dirt Series champion and the 03 Connor out of Clayton, Georgia, it is Randy Nichols. Randy Nichols. 12.597, 12.597. For Jonathan Davenport, Randy Nichols, first lap at a 13.529. 13.529. Second lap, even faster at a 12.459. 12.459. So Jonathan Davenport sets the pace for qualifying tonight. That fast lap again, a 12.459. Track record, David Payne on July 9th, 2015 at a 12.243. So that is the track record here at Tri-County Racetrack. Here comes Kenny Collins in 1C out of Colbert, Georgia, and in car number 4 out of Augusta, Georgia. Oh, he gets into the berm off of turn number 2. Brian Ligon in car number 4. And the caution flag will wave. Ligon got up into the berm there in 1 and 2. And Kenny Collins goes around down in turn number 4. They're going to try it again. It's a 12.243. David Payne, July 9th in 2015. All right, here we go. We'll be coming to the green flag. We'll try it again. Brian Ligon out of Augusta, Georgia, car number 4, down the main straightaway. Ligon will be at a 12.781. Kenny Collins will be at a 12.690. All right, so Brian Ligon's fastest lap was a 12.602 there in car number 4. And Kenny Collins goes to second at a 12.585. All right, so his best lap will count. The second one did not count. He gets one lap. So a 12.690 will be Kenny Collins' lap. 12.690. And that'll bring out the next two qualifiers. The 2012 Tarheel 50 winner, the car number 8 machine of Coach David Payne out of Murphy, North Carolina, and car number 7 out of Dawsonville, Georgia, it's Donald McIntosh. Donald McIntosh in the Motorsports Rocket Chassis number 7. Here they come, checkered flag in the air for David Payne. Here he comes, Elena Cook down the main straightaway. Donald McIntosh will bring that Rocket number 7 at a turn number 4 down the main straightaway. And we'll see what he can finish it up. David Payne goes to second quick time, 12.540, 12.540, and McIntosh at a 12.623. It's Davenport, Payne, Ligon, McIntosh, Collins, and Michael Barnett out of Hayesville, North Carolina, and the 45 out of Harriman, Tennessee. That is Doug Smith. Here we go, the next two qualifiers down the back straightaway. Michael Barnett at 34. And Michael Barnett sputtering down the main straightaway in car number 34. Michael Barnett in that Rayburn chassis. And Doug Smith in car number 45, also in a Rayburn. Oh my goodness, a pair of Rayburns out there in qualifying. Oh man. And we'll finish it up for qualifying down the main straightaway. Michael Barnett turned a 14.621, a 14.621, and Doug Smith turned a 14.156 for the pair of Rayburn chassis. Oh my goodness, the only two, and they qualified together, those Rayburn chassis. My goodness, number 4 out of Hayesville, North Carolina, and at Masters Military, and car number 21, Robbie Moses out of Maryville, Tennessee, and a Vic Hill powered Longhorn chassis. And they'll come out for the two qualifying laps. Come down to Bundy's white flag down the main chute. Manny Ledford into 4, Robbie Moses in 21. FK Rodden's qualifying rolling right along. Davenport still the time to beat so far. We'll see what Ledford can do. And Betty Ledford goes to seventh quick at a 13.054. And Robbie Moses goes to sixth quick, 12.942. Here come the last two cars in Group A. It'll be the 27 at Charge and Charlie Park out of Hayesville, North Carolina, that Masters but entry. And scheduled to come out with him in car X15, the 2016 Tri-County Racetrack Champion at X15, Sean Chastain. Sean Chastain out of Murphy, North Carolina. He's made 8 Tar Heel 50 races. So Charge and Charlie Parker and the X15 of Sean Chastain, your final two qualifiers in Group A. So Charlie Parker turned a 13.604. Sean Chastain was sixth. He bumps Robbie Moses back a spot, 12.939. So Davenport the fastest in Group A at a 12.459. Davenport fast time over David Payne at a 12.540. Brian Ligon was third quick. Donald McIntosh fourth quick. Kenny Collins out of Madisonville, Tennessee. And the 96 car of Bobby Painter. Bobby Painter in 96 out of Morganton, Georgia, that Mary Wright race car. So Tim Rucker brings it down in car 47. Bobby Painter in that orange 96 car. Bobby Painter's fastest lap at a 13.912. Tim Rucker at a 14.124. So Painter and Rucker, the first two, 10 more to go. Oh my goodness, they're talking politics up here in the tower. Oh man. Oh my goodness.
I'm right in Ronald Reagan.
Oh man. Here we go. The B7 car up next out of Tiger, Georgia. It is Daniel Wilson. Daniel Wilson in that rocket chassis. And the 101, Casey Roberts. Casey Roberts, a former Tar Heel 50 winner out of Toccoa, Georgia, the Cushman Motorsports Longhorn chassis. We'll see what he can do down the main straightaway on lap number one. He goes to the top of the leaderboard, 12.612. 12.612. And Daniel Wilson will finish it up at a 13.768. Can Casey Roberts better it? He does! He gets faster. Casey Roberts, 12.480. So Davenport turned a 12.46. Casey Roberts just turned a 12.480. He goes to the top of the leaderboard in Group B. Up next to qualifying, car number 7, out of Cleveland, Tennessee, Craig Rear, and the 38 out of Murphy, North Carolina, that is Jamie Oliver. Jamie Oliver in that Mastersville race car number 38. So Jamie Oliver. Jamie Oliver goes to second quick in this group at a 13-1-29. So he's behind Casey Roberts. Craig Greer turns his fastest lap at a 14-5-89. So Roberts, Oliver, Daniel Wilson, and Painter, top four so far. Five go out of Group B in qualifying. Winner, he's now a Hillbilly 100 and Magnolia State champion, Knoxville Nationals champion, the 157 at a Winfield, Tennessee, the Winfield Warrior, Mike Marler. Mike Marler, he's a two-time visitor here to Tri-County, only picked up one victory back here during the Spring Nationals race, the 76 car out of Evans, Georgia. Evans, Georgia driver Brandon Overton in the Warrior race car with a Clemens racing engine under the hood. Mike Marler in a 12-6-1-2. See what Overton can do. He goes to third in a 12-9-0-9. We'll see what Mike Marler can do on lap number two, 12-5-71. So Brandon Overton goes to third quick at a 12-7-09, and Mike Marler goes to second fastest behind Casey Roberts. Marler's lap time at a 12-5-71. So Roberts at a 12-4-8-0, Marler at a 12-5-71, and Overton at a 12-7-09 so far. Up next to qualify in car 99, G. Jacob Grizzle out of Blairsville, Georgia, and the 13 of George Mashburn out of Murphy, North Carolina. Mashburn in that Mastersville race car, Grizzle in that Capital race car 99, G. Jumps the cushion off of two. So Jacob Grizzle in the 99G goes to fourth fastest at a 13-1-1-7. The 13 of George Mashburn, sixth fastest at a 13-2-51. So it's Roberts, Marler, Overton, Grizzle, and Jamie Oliver. Here comes the Schaefer Oil Southern Nationals winner from July, the Double Down Motorsports number 50 Longhorn race car, Miss Shannon Buckingham in car number 50. Also out to qualify the 56 car of Joey Standridge. Joey Standridge in car 56 from Teleco Plains, Tennessee, in an entry here tonight. We'll see what Standridge can do down the main straightaway, as well as Buckingham. Shannon Buckingham goes to third quick. So after those two, Shannon Buckingham bumps Brandon Overton down a spot. Buckingham goes to third at a 12-7-08. And looks like here that Joey Standridge at a 14-0-5-3. Casey Roberts, fastest here in group number two at a 12-4-8-0. Fastest qualifier overall tonight, the 116 out of Blairsville, Georgia, Superman Jonathan Davenport. 12-4-6-0.